Don't fear. Death is not something I care to do. You will all merely dream. You will dream of freedom, peace, anything and everything your companion hearts desire. So don't bother fighting.
Oh, just shut up.
You know, monologuing is only fun when it's not interrupted by a loudmouthed teenager with anger management issues.
Why are you even here? What do you hope to gain from making us all sleep?
I seek to gain favour from above, that's all. But that's not what you should be worrying about, because, you hear that? Tweet, tweet. It's time to sleep.
Okay. One of us needs to cause a distraction, whilst the other gets a message to the doctors about this.
I'll cause a distraction.
Okay. What's your plan?
I'm gonna shout at him.
Oi! Roofie Lord!
You know, I gave myself a cool name because I intended people to use it.
Well, I have friends so I can talk to them.
Wake them up! Tell you what, I'll do you one better. I'll let you join your friends in Dreamland. We can prance about and be sassy to your heart's content.
Oh, I think you'll find that my strength of character will keep me awake long enough to keep you in a nap. Because...
Sweet dream. Snowball.
Well, isn't that a wizard?
Oops. I thought it was on silent.
You know, I was told this house would be a good way to warm up. Build up strength and all that. So I really wasn't expecting you to be such pins in my ass.
Well, we're not all just pretty screamers. So, let me check if I've got this right. You want to put all of us in a perfect dream state where everything is perfection, right?
You're a fast learner, Miss Smith.
Well, that doesn't sound too bad.
Sarah Jane. Oh, I expected better from you. No, it's not the dream you should be worrying about. It's what'll happen to you when you're asleep.
Oh no, if they get any closer to Unit HQ, their big scary reptile protocol will take effect.
What does that mean?
It means 5 nuclear warheads will rain right above our heads.
Come in. McGann, you quite all right?
Yes, yes, obviously. Why wouldn't I be?
Well, I keep hearing you scream about nukes and wars and stuff. Man has to wonder in this road whether there's an actual threat or if you're just going mad.
No, no. That was just crippling loneliness.
I don't know why I just admitted that.
Oh my god, that's the companion alert noise!
Ah yes, that thing we both know exists. Oh dear. The Dream Lord has everyone in a coma.
There's no saving us. Save yourselves.
Did you two receive the message too?
Yes, obviously. We're all in the chat, you know.
Now is not the time to bicker, Troughton. Sarah is in danger. We need to get to the companion house right away and give him the old 1-2.
We need to take the message at face value. Companion house is down. We need to prepare.
But it's Sarah Jane!
We all have companions in there. But we have to keep our composure if we're going to defeat this Dream Lord character.
Exactly. Troughton, lock down the house. Us classics are on our own.
On it.
Well, what about the New Who bunch? What are we going to do with them?
They'll have received the message as well.
I can confirm that. Whittaker just replied with a shocked face emoji in the group chat.
Well, that seems like an appropriate way to respond to the message. I'm a genius.
Oi! I already told you, Fawn's off during training sessions.
Oh. Well, you'll be very happy I didn't. Look.
This is just a gif of a new dancing.
It doesn't have to make me low! But sorry, swipe left.
Oh. Yeah, that's a problem.
I guess lessons are over again today.
Annoyingly so.
Okay, so, what do we do about this Dream Lord guy?
You do, Sim, because I've got bloody nothing.
You do know pictures can't talk, right?
Well, they can in Harry Potter, so there.
Well, we'll be dealing with Dobby any minute, so come on. Let's put our heads together and let's think of a way of defeating this weirdo.
He's here.
What? How can you tell?
Do you not hear that sheeping?
Oh!
Oh, it's like a bloody aviary in here.
Hello, you two. I hope I'm not interrupting anything naughty.
Oh, shut up.
You. Sorry. Oh, I hope you know I was joking, by the way. About you and him. No, no. Me and my friend have been peering into your mind, your dreams. And oh, I know exactly whose Doctor's Sonic you've been fiddling with.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Oh, sure you do. Moving on, though. Let me give you a fantastical gift. Not that you'll remember it's a gift, of course. It'll just be your reality.
What are you talking about?
Tweet, tweet.
Classic Doctor's House, lockdown. Classic Doctor's House, lockdown.
Oh, they beat us to it! Oh well.
Moving Doctor's House, locked down.
Okay, the building's on lockdown.
And as we heard from the announcer, we apparently have, the classic doctors have too.
Well, it seems I've picked an interesting day to catch up with you two.
You have indeed. And with Chris and Jodie in the villain house, and Capaldi, God knows where, it's even better that you're around.
And besides the imminent danger, it's been nice to go down memory lane from the Day of the Doctor days. What say we continue watching our amazing performances to pass the timing wightly?
Is that really a good idea? I mean, this man is on his way, and we have to prepare ourselves. I mean, for starters, I don't even know who he is.
Agreed. Smith, he's one of the Orvillains, so tell us everything you know about him.
Oh, but we're about to get to the part where Clara ruins it all.
Smith!
Okay, sorry.
The Dream Lord is an interesting and powerful one-off foe from my first series. He has the power to stick you in a perfect dream state and make you think that it's real.
And how do we beat him?
It's hard to say. If he is truly on his way, then it's possible we're already in the dream. But the only way to escape the dream is death. And I'm not too keen to test that theory.
So, how do you suggest we proceed?
We proceed by not proceeding. We hide until we're sure whether we're in the dream or not. Then, we try everything in our power to escape it.
Is seeing the Dream Lord in the flesh proof enough?
With how loosely Jack plays with Doctor Who logic, I'm going to say no. But if things start running a little too smoothly, if life is looking a little too peachy clean, be afraid. Be very afraid.
We should let the others know of this. Is there a way of contacting them?
Not whilst in lockdown mode.
Besides, I'm sure they've all watched Amy's Choice. It's a real bang.
I don't think we have it.
We have to have it. Keep looking. Leave no stone unturned.
I got it. It was in the back, but I've got it. Doctor Who Series 5. Now we can actually watch this stupid episode.
I'll try and manually restart it. Oh, and if I don't come back alive, just know I'm better than you.
You wish, you Beatles reject.
Right. Right. Lights are easy, but anything else is a no-go, I'm afraid.
Wait. We are not all here.
I'm here. Nobody panic.
You're not exactly hard to miss.
Right back at you, Palmyra.
Davison and Hartnell, I'll go get them.
People need to stop leaving this room. Splitting up is stupid and has never worked.
I'll come straight back with them and Trouton. But for now, you will stay safe if you pick a hiding spot and stay there and stay quiet.
You do know you're telling Tom Baker to keep quiet, right?
I am excellent at keeping quiet!
You'll be fine.
These cards are bloody ridiculous. Can't even play Gear Fish with the silly little things. Fabulous artwork, though. Quit your worrying, Davison. If we can survive Moffat, Scarecrow, and all the other buggers, we can survive some pansy called Dreamy Lord.
You know, you're the second person today who just can't quite seem to get my simple name right.
Oh, boo-hoo.
Still think I'm a pansy?
Somewhat, yes.
I guess there's no point in trying to convince you otherwise, then.
Honestly, my boy, I'm surprised I'm still awake.
Okay, seriously, are you okay? Because you are far too chill about all this.
I've been up against far greater evils than you. Besides, the worst I'll get from you is a nap. And I could really do with one of those.
Well, in that case, your wish is my command.
Thank you.
Jolly?
I swear she was just here.
Well, there's no need to question that. Time to just blindly follow that. You're dead. And you're Northern? Are we done stating the obvious? I've got some news for you. Again, I've just got an urge to blindly go with this. Your stating of the obvious, practically breaking the fourth wall, has always been your finest feature, Chris.
Finally, someone said it! Thank you.
And now, on to my surprise. Oh! Christ! How bad is my peripheral vision, eh? What's up, Witty?
I'm here to say that I no longer want training from you.
Really? It was just the other day you were saying how much you appreciated the training.
It's because I got sacked and Chibnall is handing the Doctor reins back to you.
Holy shit! This is all amazing. Not only do I have a big weight off my back, thank you, but my best friend's back, and I'm the bloody Doctor again!
Oh, this is just what I've always dreamed of.
Hang on.
Oh, who cares? Banana party, anyone? Woo! You're right down there. Dumpy bit of floor, is it?
David.
Oh, thank God you're here. There's this guy, right? He's called Dreamy Lord or something.
I know.
He's dead.
What? Already? Weak villain.
What even had you scared of this strangely attractive weirdo?
He knew somehow. About us.
Well, you can drop all those worries now and enjoy your life as normal. Oh, I've got an idea. Well, shall we go and kill all of your Twitter enemies in an Order 66 style massacre?
Oh, I love you.
As is everyone witty. Everyone without exception.
You do know you're basically backed up against a window, right? Hello again. Shoddy and predictable.
Are you critiquing a writer?
No. No, I would never.
Good.
Phew. Oh, buggery got away!
Perhaps if I stare at it long enough, the problem will fix itself.
Forget the defense system. He's already in the house.
Damn. Well, I suppose we'll have to defend the house the old-fashioned way.
Any second now, he'll burst through this door and try to make us sleep.
So we take him down before he has the chance.
Mm-hmm. Nice pistol, by the way. The Smith & Wesson?
Yeah, something like that. We've eaten a bunch of skinches now. Oh, I must say, I love this pirate look you've got going on.
Yes, thank you. It's quite a fun aesthetic, actually. We should talk more, right?
Buggery got away!
After all this blows over, who fancies watching World War?
What do you think he's doing?
I think he's going for the others. That was adorable.
Must you be such a prick?
When you have magical powers like I do, you'll have to be the biggest prick in the universe because, well, no one's awake to tell you otherwise.
Speaking of, do you hear that?
Hold it. No, no, no. No, please!
Children hosts.
Hey! We have names, you know.
And they are?
Girl and boy. Look, it doesn't matter. We can't all be famous actors.
Girl, we practiced this.
Sorry. We are here today to show off the result of the Best Doctors of All Time list!
Voted by our lovely viewers. Thank you!
Let me guess, my lovely son-in-law won the vote again.
David Tennant? That weirdo! No, you won! Again, you've been the most popular doctor for 20 years running!
More popular than David?
By far!
This is the best day of my life.
Moving on from this famous cricket player.
What the fuck?
We get on to our next and best guest, William Hartnell!
It's a pleasure to be here on Spiffingly Doctor Who.
What is happening?
And might I comment on how nothing has progressed since the 1960s?
I couldn't agree more with you, Doc.
Doctor. Let's not shorten what's already perfect.
Well said. Now, how does it feel to have been the Doctor for 60-odd years?
Oh, my boy, it's what I've always dreamed of.
I am so confused!
Wait, you dreamed of... we're dreaming. Dream Lord, we're dreaming.
Oh, yes, yes, yes.
We are dreaming, aren't we?
Oh, poo. Oh, we did it. We're awake, we did it. But how?
Well, I'm not entirely sure, but if you don't mind, my boy, I'm going to sit this one out.
Oh, really? Why?
Because Arthur Moffat took out his revenge, and Scarecrow gassed me, and just last week Adam Mitchell getting inside my head. I'll be honest, I've gotten bloody sick of all these silly little adventures.
So, in short, you're getting too old for this shit?
I would never swear! Now fuck off and sort this shit out.
Okay. Yes!
I think we watch this now.
Just reminding you that we're here.
Patiently waiting our turn in the new Doctor's house.
I still think we should plan something better.
Well, what more can we do?
I think we should go out there and hunt this creep down before he can do anything else to harm us.
The only thing we can do is fight our way out of the dream once inside it. If we do that, he has no power over us.
And then what?
We beat him to a bloody pulp! Or something to that effect.
A bit graphic.
Well, if this is the plan we're going with, I'm going to take a nap. Wake me up when he gets here, will you?
What are you doing?
Are you stupid? Alright, Jesus.
What's that?
It's the front door. Someone's trying to get in.
Is it the Dream Lord?
No. He's my father-in-law.
Hello in there. Could you let me in? The defense system's still online. If you're still awake, that is.
You would not believe the day I've had.
It's an honor to meet you, Mr. Baker. Truly, it is.
Oh, someone's name is here.
I didn't do that.
Sorry. That was the funniest thing I've ever seen.
Night. God, I hate this place.
Now!
You're surrounded, Mr. Lordy.
Dear Sarah Jane.
Join her, John. Join her in Dreamland. You can't outrun sleep, Sylvester.
Just you bloody watch me.
I'm watching an old man fight a losing battle.
No, what you are seeing is the man receiving his second wind. And the man who has faced greater evils than you will ever encounter. And I will destroy you with my two bi- Oh no, that'll do it. Oh.
Ace!
I'm coming, Ace!
Snotty, Ace, you're looking a tad different.
Did you do acid again without me, Professor?
Me? Never! Come on now, Ace, we've got work to do.
You mean drop acid, right?
Yes, obviously!
Okay, I'm coming.
Ding, 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 ding. Bam! Nice.
Well then, Evelyn, I suppose it's time for us to get back to the TARDIS. Hi, my name's Colin Baker, and you will only know me as the Sixth Doctor in Big Finish's audio productions, as every live-action episode of mine was burned in one big bonfire by me. Yeah.
To Tom Baker. Ooh, that's me. Unlimited jelly babies! Ah, yes, excellent! Yes, I am this easy to please.
Oh, look at them. They're like adorable puppies, dreaming of corners to piss on.
That's disgusting.
Sorry, sir. Just taking pride in my work.
As you should. But there's still a few doctors left. Oh, my God. Finish it now.
Hey, McGann. What's up?
Oh, thank God. The Dream Lord hasn't got to you yet.
Thankfully, my office is secure. But that also means I can't do anything to help. Sorry.
It's all right, because Davison and Hartnell figured out a way of escaping the Dream.
They did. That's great.
I'll work on freeing everyone. You stay where you are. I'll call you when it's all over. Stay safe. Okay then, Hartnell, you hang tight. I'm gonna go free the New Who bunch.
I will hang tighter than a tightly hung. Just leave.
Okay.
Pollen!
What?
The Dream Lord, he's really made up of spacey wacy pollen. Can't believe I've only just remembered this rather crucial detail. I'm very sorry.
So he's made of pollen. Why is that so crucial?
Well, in theory, if we hold up a small fan to him, he might just blow away in the wind.
Surely the pollen would just reform.
Yes, perhaps. But right now, it's the only plan we've got.
Well, lucky for us.
I have this big old fan for vanity picture purposes.
Oh, of course you do.
It's time to set a trap. Don't forget we have to lure him here too. How do you intend on doing that?
Something tells me you don't have to worry about that. I'll be with you shortly.
He's here.
Tenant, Davison, you stay here and set up the fan. Me and her will, distract.
Distract him? Yes, yes, I will be.
Until the end of his life. Let's do this.
Dream Lord.
Finally.
Someone gets it.
Oh bugger, I forgot to change the batteries, didn't I?
Doctor number 11. You're the man who defeated me in my universe.
Your universe?
Where I'm from, the Doctor is real. He's even come here before. Bumped into Mr. Tennant, if I remember correctly.
Oh, I see. Well, if that's the case, then it really must burn to see the face of the man who, with a single breath, dismissed you into the time vortex.
Oh, it does. I will be victorious this time.
I love chatter. Tweet, tweet! No, no, no. No, I will not let you win.
I go through this door, and by my count, I've won. So shut it and sleep!
What a mighty hubris you have. Ha! Ha! Oh! Hello, Pons. Good to see familiar faces.
Oh, Doctor, we've just come round to say that she's no longer attracted to you, and I've found someone who's not a complete slut.
Oh, I am so pleased for you both. Improvements on both sides.
Oh, and we've also universally decided that bow ties are the best piece of fashion. In fact, I'm going to go get one right now.
I'm in heaven!
Oh, it's not working.
Would you actually help?
Well, it should only take one man to get his own fan working.
Oh, well, your son-in-law is struggling here. Help a boy out!
Well, here's a tip. Get good.
Oh, how childish.
Final two. I cannot tell you how good this is gonna feel.
I'm sorry. Did you say final two?
I think you miscounted.
Of course. John Hurt must have messed up my count.
You saw me earlier, how stupid are you?
Well, I suppose if people only know you from a crap TV movie, Mr. I'm Half Human, then you're gonna be pretty easy to forget, aren't you?
You think that frightens me? Or offends me? I've heard it all before, and worse.
Oh, I don't care.
I just want you unconscious.
Can we not discuss this first?
And what on earth do you hope to gain from that?
Oh, just the few seconds the tenant needs to realize the fan isn't plugged in! Sleep!
Well, we can add Dream Lord to our list of defeated villains, eh?
He was different, though, don't you think?
What makes you say that?
Well, you know, the whole different universe thing.
We can talk about that later. Right now, we need to focus on waking everyone up.
Yes, good idea. How do you suggest we do it?
Well, me and Hartnell woke ourselves up by dreaming the same dream. And I believe we were doing that because we were touching each other's clothes. So, theoretically, if we fall asleep, touching another doctor's clothes, we can get into their dream and boom, wake them up.
Right, sounds easy enough. You start with Tennant and I'll go with Smith.
Hold your horses. I've got a better way of doing it. It's, dimensionally transcendental.
Don't you try to technobabble the technobabble king.
Sorry, friend.
Ah, that's alright. Anyways, I think it's my turn.
So, how do you think he got here?
I'm not sure. Perhaps we'll never know.
Well, I suppose that's not really a bad thing.
Yes, I'd hate for there to be some sort of greater evil, so to speak.
Well, anywho, I'm gonna make some tea.
Anyone for a little spot?
Ooh. No old man!
Ooh, one for me as well.
Scotland, being tormented by this stupid, bloody... Crushing!
Lieutenant Clara just throw the Fez into the bright light that I just jumped into?
She sounds cute.
Oh, would you calm yourself, Captain Libido?
Okay, watch your heads! Wait, hold on.
And you picked her to travel with you. Why?
Because she's a mystery, wrapped in an enigma, and wrapped in a skirt that's just a little too tight. Black, I knew I was skinny, but we just got knocked over by a Fez.
There's a bunch of rocks in here!
Love.